Hey everyone, I hope you're well out there in guitar land, wherever that may be for you. God, I've done so many commentaries already on David Gilmour. It's going to be tough to find something new to say. But let's give it a shot anyway, shall we? It might be short, we'll see. This is my number 48, greatest underrated, underappreciated, and or unknown guitar solo of all time, with David Gilmour and High Hopes from Pink Floyd's 1994 album, The Division Bell. With this choice at number 48, I get to do two of my absolute favorite things in the world. Play David Gilmour and play slide guitar. Something that I had no idea how to do just a couple of months ago, and all it took was lots of practice and determination. Kids, practice your guitar. Now, I know that I'm no Derek Trucks, not even close, but it's a nice technique to have in one's arsenal and under one's fingers. Plus, it's a lot of fun. It's such a delicate and precise technique. It just boggles my mind to listen and watch some of the masters like Johnny Winter and Derek Trucks, and the like, just rip into it and be so amazing at it, considering how precise one has to be when playing slide. Practice, I guess, and lots of it. Just like anything, I suppose. Like I said, I love playing slide guitar, but it's not a technique that I'm willing to put in the countless hours to try and master. I just enjoy these relatively intermediate level slide solos, like this one and Layla by Duane Allman, which I covered a few months ago. This entry was a bit of a last-minute idea, actually. I've already got about 50 solos all lined up for this project, and this was not one of them. Didn't even think of it, really, to tell the truth, and none of you guys brought it up when I posed the question to you a couple of months ago. It took a visit to one of Rick Beato's recent videos in where he has a look at his idea of 10 underrated guitar solos. Good video, by the way. His top 10 choices were all great, but that's not where I wanted to get my inspiration. It was the comments that I wanted to dig through. His channel is huge, like 1.5 million subscribers or something, and I knew that there would be hundreds, if not thousands, of comments to this video, with many of them adding their own 2 cents as to their choices of great underrated guitar solos. This solo was mentioned in one of those comments with lots of thumbs up and lots of sub-comments. Ooh, I thought, forgot about High Hopes. Actually, haven't listened to that song in ages and had kind of forgotten about it. Forgotten that it was even a slide solo, to tell the truth. One re-listened to the solo and I knew that I had to add it to my list. It's just a gorgeous, sorrowful guitar solo and a Gilmour solo that not enough people talk about compared to his more famous solos. Most probably because it stems from a somewhat lesser-known Pink Floyd track from the David Gilmour-led era during the 90s, from 1994's Division Bell, like I said. An album that generally sits somewhere in the middle or even further down as far as ranking goes when looking at the greatest Pink Floyd albums of all time. Some love the album, while others find it a bit uneven at times, rather long on atmospherics and short on strong, cohesive, and melodic songs. I personally fall into the latter category, unfortunately. You know, some great guitar playing on it for sure. How could there not be? But in my opinion, the songwriting is a bit weak and disjointed at times, but you know, it's just my opinion. But not this song, High Hopes. This song is definitely the highlight of the album, along with the instrumental Marooned, which is also great. And it's also one of Gilmour's own personal favorites. And like I said, one of my favorites as well. And there's also just a gorgeous live rendition of this one from the live Pulse concert video. And if you've seen the Pulse rendition of this track, you would know that David Gilmour does not actually play traditional slide on this one. He rarely played traditional slide on anything. He plays a lap pedal steel guitar, something that he's always just felt more comfortable doing as compared to more traditional slide playing. He was actually playing pedal steel guitars as far back as the 60s when it came to his slide work. Now, the way that Gilmour used the pedal steels really comes down to comfort for him and not much else, really. I don't know much about pedal lap steel guitars, but apparently the early Fender 1000s that Gilmour used had 2 necks with 8 strings on each, of which Gilmour apparently only used 6, just like a regular guitar. And the pedals, of which there were like 10, I think, on the floor, Gilmour didn't use the pedals at all, or so I've read, and often just removed them. He would eventually switch to a Jedson lap steel, which was closer to a regular guitar with the traditional 6 strings and no pedals, but just, you know, played like that. So basically a slide guitar that you can sit down at and you know, hold the slide in your hand instead of on your finger, you know, and play like that. On a little stand, right? So other than that, there's no particular magic to the lap steel that can't be achieved with a normal guitar and a finger slide. You know, though hitting the high notes on a regular guitar is really tough because you have no fret guides other than the pickups. And on the Jedson, there's like 29 frets, making it much easier to hit those high notes. But on a regular guitar, you know, when you're way up here, you're kind of just like hoping for the best. Regardless, just a beautiful and ethereal slide solo from Gilmour on this one, and one of his best, thus its inclusion here on my list. Quick word about the tone on this one before I go, should you want to give this one a shot yourself. Like most Gilmour solos, this one is drenched in effects. I personally use this guitar, of course, humbucker in the bridge position, loads of compression before the amp to get those notes to carry and ring for as long as possible. I went with a double Marshall Plexi setup with this one, using a software, Bias FX 2 Pro. Not much gain on the amps, about 4, but the volume cranked. Tube driver with gain on 0 set before the amps for a boost. And then loads of delay and reverb. Digital delay set at about 440 milliseconds with about four repeats and lots of plate reverb for that big, empty, airy tone. Not your traditional Gilmour setup, to tell the truth, but it worked for me, I think, after a whole lot of tinkering, of course. It's the delay and the reverb here that are definitely the key. Anyway, that's all I got to say about that one. Hope you like my take on that one. Also, hope you're well in your little guitar corner of the world, and we will see you next time. Cheers.